the second chance opportunities that Miami was getting, just the inability to secure the rebound and that after their first attempt. Did you feel like that was the difference tonight?
Yeah, I thought we got some balls ripped out of our hands. They got some second chance points, and that's just deflating, you know. And we had opportunities for transition, and we missed, you know, some chippies and some bunnies, and, you know, got our shot blocked, and then they went down the other end. And I just don't feel like we didn't match that physicality, I think, in the second half.
Coming out to such a strong start tonight, obviously the emphasis on both the ball screen defense, but also offensively jumping out in front 10-0. Did you feel like at any point in this game, because of Miami's constant pressure, constant trying to run, that maybe fatigue set in at any point?
Yeah, I mean, we were definitely a little tired. And, you know, when you don't finish shots, you create transition for Miami. So, yeah, it was tough. I mean, I think our kids played hard. I just felt like we got fatigued. But I thought they won the battle, like the 50-50 balls for us, for them.
So many young players on this team obviously getting so much playing time. Do you kind of see some of the youth coming out tonight and some of the turnovers and the decisions and just not a complete game?
Yeah. We just had major, you know, we had breakdowns at crucial opportunities when the game's close and, you know, they get to push it or, you know, we end up fouling. They get to the free throw line a lot in the second half. So just, yeah, things like that. And,
final line shows Sarah I with 14 points in the game, and obviously a lot of them coming late. What was Miami doing to try to kind of keep the ball away from her, especially early on in the game?
They really sagged off of Lauren. I mean, they just let us take that high post jump shot all night, and we didn't, you know, we didn't handle that well, and so tried to get SI some touches, and when she did, she got fouled and went to the free throw line for us.
Last thing, this Sunday back at home, another athletic team in Georgia Tech coming to JPJ. What can we expect from the Yellow Jackets a few days out?
Similar, you know, they're a team that presses. I mean, the ACC has an MO. You know, they're going to press. They're athletic. They try and attack the rim. I mean, we're following suit here, you know, with a lot of athleticism.
We talked to Coach Boyle about feeling a little fatigued. Did you guys feel like their pace and speed sped you guys up offensively?
Yeah, definitely. And I just felt like our guards, they ran into foul trouble. Mickey was in foul trouble. Lauren was in foul trouble also. And I just felt like that we were letting our defense affect our offense, and we wasn't getting the shot that we needed, and I just felt like that affected us on defense. Yeah, fatigue played with that, so I felt like we got tired a little bit.
Last thing for you, and we'll let you go. It's obviously a team now trying to bounce back from a loss once again. I know you're one of the leaders in this team. I mean, what is said now to regroup heading back to home to face Georgia Tech?
We just got to regroup. This game is over. We can't have it back anymore. We just have to do a better job of the in and out game. I feel like that will help us a lot, because I feel like the ball comes in, then the guards have a better shot, and I can take my man one-on-one. But yeah, we just have to regroup, just keep our mind on the goals, and I think we'll be fine.